What's up, everyone? Welcome back to One Strange Adventure. Welcome to the next video, and welcome to Mackinac Island. Before we get this video started, I just want to say thank you to our patrons.
Yes, because you guys are awesome, and thank you so much for your support.
All right, let's get the video started. I don't know about you guys, but whenever we're away from the rig for a long time, we don't leave the propane on. We'll actually turn the propane off. Turn propane off, turn the hot water heater off, unplug things. We have the animals in there, so we don't want take a chance of anything happening. So mitigate as much risk as possible. Today we are on our way to Mackinac Island. We are here at dock number 3.
Yes.
And we're going to be hopefully taking the one that goes under the bridge.
I think so.
Yeah.
I think the 10 o'clock one goes under the bridge.
Yep, so we've made it here just in time. The line is forming and we're getting ready to head over to the island, guys. If you've never seen Mackinac Island, this is gonna be a treat.
You ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Come on.
Excited to be going back to the island?
Yes.
It's been 2 years.
2 long years.
Yep.
I think it's a good tradition to come up here at least every couple of years.
We're ready. Excuse
to
me.
Go. Thank
you. Stop. We're heading out now.
Yeah.
So we're
So this one doesn't go under the bridge.
I know.
This is
so we'll try to get that on the way back.
The captain said this is the icebreaker boat that they use in the wintertime. But
it's big and holds a lot of people.
But it's so crowded that they use the bigger one so that we can get more people over to the island in one shot.
Yeah.
So maybe we can catch the bridge on the way back.
Yeah, maybe.
We'll see.
We'll see. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to One Strange Adventure. Welcome to the next video, and welcome to Mackinac Island.
So today, we're going to go on a carriage tour with the horses, like what's behind us, except for those ones are carrying supplies, so we gotta go find the ones that carry people. With the carriage tour, it takes you around to the different areas of the park, or the island, not the park, but the whole island, and we have to determine, will it actually let you like get off and explore each area, or do you have to like ride the same one each time you get back on it? So we'll find that out so we can determine like when we can go to the fort and explore as well.
So if you've never been here, the first thing you get to is like a town area.
It's like walking into a amusement park.
Yeah, it kind of is. I think last time we were here, we said it was kind of like Disneyland.
Yeah.
When you first get on the island. But there's a bunch of different stuff. Oh, the fudge. If you guys could have smell-o-vision right now.
It's the shops, it's where you rent your bikes, it's
right.
Where you do the carriage tours. Like literally like all your different restaurants, everything is right here in this little hub.
That's amazing.
So it makes it really crowded and the streets are lined with the bikes that you rent.
Right.
We gotta go that way.
And horses.
Where's those carriage
tours? Oh, carriage tours. All right, so we gotta go over there.
Okay, so we were right. You can get on the tour and then...
The carriage tour.
get off at different locations.
Yep.
Except for Arch Rock. Arch Rock, you have to get back on the same tour that drops you.
You get 10 minutes.
You get 10 minutes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we can take the tour up to the fort.
Which we have tickets for as part of our Mac Pass.
Yep. And then we can get off there and explore and then catch the next tour as it comes through.
Yep. So it's really worth it to just go ahead and get the Mac Pass with the carriage and use the carriage as like a taxi around the island.
Yep. Yep. Because it's $7 a person for if you call a taxi. And you have to wait for them to come get you.
Right. Yeah, so it's definitely worth it. You don't save any money by getting the Mac Pass, but it's just convenient that everything is together.
Yeah, and you get all your tickets.
Yeah. All right. Well, we're going to hop on the carriage tour. We're
going to
show you guys, show you guys around the island a little bit more. Ride, which takes you to the Butterfly Conservatory.
Yep, and you drive past the Grand Hotel, but you can't get off at the Grand Hotel, so we have to still go back to that.
Yep. And there's food and, you know, drinks and everything inside, and bathrooms. So if you're wondering, this is actually a really good stop around lunchtime.
Yes. We don't know what the food has yet, other than donuts.
Well, they got brats.
Michaela spotted donuts, and that's all she wanted.
It's donuts, popcorn, brats, hot dogs. It's like concession stand food, but.
Yeah.
It's a good place.
Yeah.
Plus, there's a big green area, big open area to have like a picnic or something like that.
Yeah, a little pavilion. They have tables and then covered porch over there.
Yep, we're going to get back on the carriage. I think we're going to do the butterfly, or at least check into it.
Yeah.
And then we're going to get back on the carriage, and it takes us to the fort.
Yep.
And we already have tickets to the fort, so we're going to do that tour.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I like it.
You enjoying it so far?
I am.
Mackinac Island is just beautiful. It's so pretty.
Our horses' names were Harvey and Cooper.
Yep, Cooper wasn't wanting them. To walk.
His legs were a little crooked like Comet's.
Yeah, so. Poor guy. They get worked.
Yeah.
But no, it's just beautiful out here. This is amazing.
It's pretty cool though. They said that the horses only work 5 hours a day total.
Yep.
The driver is the only driver for that team of horses.
2 baths a day.
They get a bath in the morning and a bath in the evening when they're done. And of course, unlimited hay.
Yeah, they...
And they get off one day a week.
Horses are royalty here.
Yes. He said there's five vets and one doctor on the island.
So you know the priorities of the horses.
So.
Yep. Now, we have seen a bunch of e-bikes. We keep getting asked that question. Can you bring e-bikes over here? Because bicycles are like the main mode of transportation.
Yep.
He said that the workers and people that live on the island can have e-bikes.
Yes.
So we're still not sure if you can actually bring an e-bike over, although we did see a lot of them downtown.
Right, but we don't know if it's just employees on their day off.
Right, so we're gonna keep digging into that one and see if you can actually bring an e-bike over.
Yeah, we'll have to ask somebody that actually knows the answer.
Yep. All right, let's go check out the conservatory and see what we can get into around here before we head over to the fort. We're in the Butterfly Observatory.
Wings of Mackinac.
Yeah. Oh, they're so cute. So I asked them what they do in the wintertime. They don't live very long. So what they do is they just stop replacing them until they eventually just all die off. It's kind of sad.
It is sad, but it's not like they're killing them.
They're going through their natural lifespan.
Do that.
But yeah, no, this is really cool. It's $11 a person, $11 for an adult. So it's $44 for the four of us walk there.
I think it's $5 for a kid.
Yeah, so, but it's really pretty. We didn't do this the first time. So this is a different side of Mackinac Island.
You did say that they will land on you and they have to check you before you leave to make sure there's none on your back.
And watch the path as you're walking.
I love that.
Yeah? Something else to experience on the island.
The kids loved it. We loved it.
Yeah.
It's a good day.
It is.
You said when you walked out, you said it was amazing.
It was awesome.
I've never met. go buy tickets to the fort, you're basically already in the town. You remember seeing the fort on the first half of the tour?
We just left Arch Rock.
Yes, we didn't get to talk at Arch Rock because
we only got six minutes on the tour.
You get 6 minutes at a stop, and that's including the restroom.
So if you want to see Arch Rock and actually like be there for a minute because it's super crowded, you need a little extra time, just walk there or ride a bike there.
Yeah.
Because
you can go back.
You can't hop off of one carriage and get on another from that location.
Yeah, that's the only downside, is because they only give you 6 minutes. But it is worth seeing. You might not be able to get a picture there. Like, we didn't get to take our picture there, but we could still see it and video it. But we couldn't wait in line for the photos.
Yep. So now we are at Fort Mackinac.
Yeah.
So we're going to go check this out because we haven't gotten to see this yet.
Nope, we couldn't go in last time because of the pups.
Yep, so another thing to do on Mackinac Island. All right, so if you get to go to Mackinac Island, definitely add the fort to the list. They do tours, they do groups, they do like cannon and rifle demonstrations. It's really fun. And now here's some history about the fort itself. So the original fort was actually over in Mackinac City. However, it was too vulnerable, so the British actually moved the fort over to Mackinac Island in 1780. Now in 1875, Mackinac National Park was established. In 1895, the fort is closed. Mackinac National Park becomes the Mackinac Island State Park. And then in 1959, Fort Mackinac reopens as a living history museum.
What do you think? I love that writing desk.
I thought you would.
Alright guys, we have been to some shops. We've been on the carriage ride.
Yes, we went to Arch Rock. We went to the Wings of Mackinac.
Yeah.
For the butterflies.
The Butterfly Observatory.
Yeah.
We've done
Fort Mackinac.
Fort Mackinac, which was pretty cool.
Now we're gonna walk past the governor's house.
And one of the main attractions of the island, we paid to go into the Grand Hotel.
Yeah.
So we're taking you guys there. Now.
Yes, it's $10 a person to go in and tour the Grand Hotel and to see the shops of the Grand Hotel. And you can sit on the porch if it's not dinner time, but they said dinner time gets really busy.
Which is what time we're getting
there. Which is what time we're getting there because it's 4:30.
Yep.
So we don't know if we'll be able to sit on the porch or not, but we'll at least, you know, get some video footage of the longest front porch or longest covered porch.
Front porch in the world.
In the world.
It took 93 days for them to build it. That's insane.
Build the whole building, not just the porch.
That long ago. That's pretty cool.
Yeah,
all right, Governor's House, then Grand Hotel.
And then we have to go get fudge.
Of course. We can't come here without getting fudge.
Can't leave without fudge.
Yeah, so let's let's go. Now, you do have to have tickets to get into the Grand to tour the shops and stuff. It's $10 a person.
Oh, let's talk.
Or you can do a buffet dinner, which is $75 a person.
I think it's 75. No, the lunch was 75.
The lunch was 75.
I don't know how much the dinner was.
Yeah.
But let's talk for a second, because we walked here from the fort. But if you wait, you can actually get the ride on the horses.
The carriage.
And then the same tour comes back and drops people off at the front.
You need to take it down to Main Street.
Take it back down to Main Street, depending on what time they stop running.
Probably the easiest way to do it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're going to get your steps in. Either way, you're going to get your steps in on this island.
Yeah.
So just know that.
And if you're handicapped accessible, instead of doing a wheelchair, they do have the electric scooters where you have to reserve them in advance. And there's two taxis, and two of the tour carriages actually can let those scooters on. They have ramps in the back.
Oh, cool.
So depending, you just have to reserve it.
Yeah. said this wine bar right here used to be a ladies' room in Prohibition, because if the police came and raided the place, they went check the ladies' room. It's pretty smart. Then they have some doors you can actually get out and kind of escape through the back. That's pretty awesome.
This is the terrace room.
Well, that's fancy.
But the doors are shut.
Looks like it's stuck in the 70s, but it's fancy.
And that's the art gallery.
Yeah.
Where Nick is at.
I could get used to this. What do you think? Yeah. I could get used to this. Just hanging out on the grand patio. The grand front porch of the grand hotel. So nice. It's very pretty. It's fancy. It's definitely fancy.
She said, what are you filming? Okay, we have a YouTube channel. She was like, have you seen The Secret Garden? Like, no. She's like, literally, like, it's a secret. So you need to go see it. So there's this like wood chip path through these evergreens to a secret garden. So let's go see where the secret garden is.
It is the painting.
So if you ever get to come to the island, the Secret Garden is right by the... I can't tell you, it's a secret. It wouldn't be a secret garden if I told everybody where it's at.
It's a walking path.
We were just talking as we were walking down. I think one of the cool things about this island is just the fact that there is no time. Like, there's nothing that's rushed.
Right, so you can rush yourself, of course. So, like, if you get here at 10 and you know you have to be back home by 4,
right,
to let the dogs out,
but for like
then
tours,
you can rush. But
there's no times on our tour tickets.
Yeah, it's just
you get there when you get there.
Like, even us purchasing them, I purchased them at the beginning of the week and on Monday, and they're good until August. So they're the whole season, and you just get to use them one time. But you choose when you come.
Right, so you're on your own time.
Yeah.
It's so cool. It's just really nice.
And, so,
and there's order. Like, Nick was saying, it's silent order. It's like everybody just knows what to do. Like, there's nobody like running each other off the roads.
Or yelling at each other. Like, the horse and buggies, if someone's going slow on the right, they just know to stay towards the right. And then the one that's going faster goes around it.
Yeah.
Like, there's no blinkers or horns or whatever.
Right. Yeah, it's so cool. Such a unique place.
Yeah, definitely. It's worth an experience.
All right, if you know anything about Mackinac Island, you know that the island is known for its fudge, and we can't leave without getting fudge. So here we are at Murdoch's fudge. So we're going to get some fudge before we leave, and then we're going to go hit the ferry. Another cool thing is once you're done, let's walk back to the dock.
Yeah.
Catch a ferry back to the island. Back to the mainland.
This one goes to the main one, which is the last one we parked at. We had to go to dock number 2. This is one, ramp 2.
1 and 3. All right, we'll see. See which one it takes us to. All right, well, that does it for Mackinac Island.
Sad.
It went too fast. We did all of that in one day.
I know. Well, and so we were talking earlier about working at your own pace, and we should have gotten there earlier in the day so we could even done more stuff.
Or stay
overnight.
Of course, we can't with the animals, but if you plan to go, take 2 days to do it, I think that's perfect.
Well, and there is, I think one of the hotels and a couple of the bed and breakfasts will let you bring pets, but typically it's only one animal.
Three.
We have 3. So
and 2 kids, so that's 5.
So So I didn't ask, I didn't chance it. You know, we just left the pups at home since they're monitored and have a generator backup, and
we're good.
We knew they were safe.
All right, so we do have a Patreon. If you're interested in learning more about that, there's a link below. Go check that out. I mean, look,
we appreciate any support you guys give us, even if it's just liking the video. It's like,
and a shout out to our members. Thank you guys for supporting us.
Thank y'all so much.
Yeah. All right, guys, we hope you enjoyed Mackinac Island today. It is one of our favorite places that we have visited. That's the second time now, so.
Nick said he wants to live there.
They want to live there. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you really like it, make sure you subscribe.
And please ring the bell so you get notified when we release our next video.
Till the next strange adventure.
Keep making your own.